Hello YouTubers, welcome to today's edition of Programming Wizards. Today we are going to concentrate, this video today we designed it specifically for absolute beginner. If you've never programmed, you're in the right place. So what we're going to do is that the first thing, we'll learn how to edit various properties of the labels. This one, this second one here. In the design view, then we'll also learn how to edit the properties in dynamically through the code, and then we are going to examine various types of properties, the most commonly used properties, things like border style, back color, pro color, font, text, etc. Then at last we'll run our program. So the first thing, open up your Visual Studio. You'll encounter this setup page, click new project. If you've not encountered the setup page, come to file, new project. We'll create our project. I'll name it intro to labels. Intro to labels, okay? So I'm going to compile mine under .NET 4.5, .NET Framework 4.5, but you can choose any other. It depends on the target machine that the application will be installed on. You can see here, there are different languages. We are using C Sharp. So please click OK. The project will load. Okay. After loading, it will bring us this startup page. I mean, this form, this is a form, this is known as a form. So, what we're going to do is that programming in C Sharp is easy. In fact, because we have all this bunch of GUI controls that have already been written for us, your job is just to drag them and drop them on the form and edit the properties. So, we'll start right away. We'll go to the labels. We'll look for the labels here. If you can't see it, just type here labels to search. Then drag the label to the form. That is our first label. I'll copy. Just click Control C or right click and choose copy. Then paste Control V, Control V, Control V, Control V. So I've pasted different labels that we're going to use. Okay, I'll just arrange them to look it, to make it look at least. Okay, so another thing that we're going to need is a button. If you don't know what a button is, don't worry, I'll explain. So we'll click the button, drag it to the form. Yeah, then we'll start editing. Now for us to customize these things the way we want, we'll edit the properties. You can see, if I select this thing here, there is the property tab just right here. If you are not seeing it, just right click the label, then click properties, you'll see it over here. So you can see all this bunch of properties. So the first property that we'll change is the text property. The text property, instead of label 1, we'll give it intro introduction to labels. Okay, that is the text property. Then we'll also come and change the text property of all these. This one, we'll very first call it first name. This one we will call last name. Then this one we'll call age. This one maybe country. Country. So that one already. For the labels, their text property, that is the text property. we've changed the text property through the design view. We've not written any single code, but actually what has happened is that the compiler Visual Studio has generated the codes in the background. So we'll come next to the second property that we are going to view. After clicking text, we are going to the name property. What the name property implies is that we'll give each of these labels names that we'll be calling from within the code. So instead of leaving it at label 1, it's a good design to give it some name that you'll be able to remember, so that you'll be able to manipulate them in the code. So this one, I'll just give it intro label. Okay, then this one I'll give it first name label. First name. I know some people may not really like this way, but it's the best practice, because there's one time that you need to maintain your code and it will be awesome. Okay, last name label. Then age. Age label. It's always a good practice. It's always a good advice that most people, you start using the recommended ways very early when you start programming. So this one will be country label. Okay, so that one we are through with the name properties of the labels. Remember, we've not touched anything about the buttons, we are still concentrating on the labels. Then we come, the second property that we're going to view is the font property. The font is just changing the font types, the font size, etc. So just click the thing, the label, the intro label, then come here, the properties, you'll see this font, then just expand it. As you can see, this name, okay, the name of the font, you can change the fonts if you like. You can see a whole bunch of font types. I'll just leave it to Microsoft Sans Serif, because I want uniformity in our program. Then the size, since it is a heading, I'll make it a little bit big. I'll make it probably 13. Okay. Then, you know, the point will leave alone. The bold, I want to make it bold. True. I want to make it italic. True. I want to underline it. True. Okay. That one, we are through with the font properties. You can see the effect. This one will leave, we are just leave the font properties intact. Then when you come again, after the font property, we have the four color property. The four color actually means it's more or less the same as the color of the font. So just come here and choose the type, the type of color that you deserve, that you would like. To me, I prefer this one over here. It looks better for me. Okay, so this is the font property. No, I mean the four color property. That is the then we can see here that we also have the first name. In this first name label, if you like, you can go ahead and change those properties that we've already discussed. But this one, to me, I will use the back color so that I explain what the back color means. Actually, what the back color means, it is the background color of that particular label, not the whole form. So make sure that you've selected the label. Then come to your menu and choose the back color. To me, I will probably give it, which one? That one? No, it's not very nice. Yeah, probably that one. So that is the back color. Then the next property is that the visibility. Visibility, we will implement it in this one, last name. I will scroll down. Remember, these things are arranged alphabetically. You can trouble it if you like. So visibility so far is true. It means that if we run this program so far, okay, let us just run it and see. If we run the program, okay, everything is visible. You see, the first name is the first name, last name, all the things are visible. So what I want to do is that I will change the visibility of this thing, and we will see the result. So after selecting it, come down to the visibility and select false. You can see how easy it is. Okay, we can't see exactly the change immediately because we are in the design view. We have to run the program first. When we run the program, here it is, you can see that there is no last name because we put it to false, okay? So that one we're through with the visibility. Now we'll come to the border style. The border style, we'll implement it in this one edge. So just click it and then come to the border style. In the border style, I'll put, we have two options, fixed single and fixed 3D. I'll try with the fixed 3D. Okay. So far, what we've been doing is that this is the design view actually. Okay, you can see the thing. This is the design view. We've not touched a single code, and yet we've produced something that is visually, at least, it's not that good, but it's better. The compiler has generated for us the codes automatically. So we'll come to this one. This one, what I'll do is that I'll just change the size, the font size, so that we can see. I'll come here and put 12. You'll see it will be a little bit bigger. So far, those are some of the properties that we've examined. We'll come now to the button. This button, it has more or less, okay, at least 3/4 of its properties are more or less the same as those of the labels. So just come and change its text property to let's write click me. And then we come and change its name property to click me button. Okay? So we'll go to the code, just double click button. So what we want to do next is that we're through with the editing of labels in the design view. Now we want to go to edit it dynamically, to make it dynamic, so that it can edit itself during the runtime. Probably, for example, when somebody clicks the button. So what we'll do is just come in this click me button, just come, and then the first thing that we want to edit is this one, this first name. I'll want to change its back color. So I'll come and say first name label dot text, not really, okay, first name label dot back color is equal to color dot, then you can choose the color that you want. Let me choose the blue. Then the name label, what did you change for the name label? Okay, I'll just change the four color of the name label. I'll say last name label dot four color is equal to color dot, I'll give it green. I'll give it green. That one is, that is the link. Then we'll come here and change the, this one for the edge label. The edge label will change its border style. Okay, so we come and say edge label. Oh, sorry, edge label dot border style. Edge label dot border style. Okay, edge label dot border style is equal to, okay, we'll come and say border style dot fixed 3D. Okay, it was fixed 3D, so we'll change it to none. Okay, then the country we had set its, okay, font size to a very large number. So instead of font size, we wanted to set its visibility right now, yeah? I think that would be better. So we just come and say country label dot visibility dot visible is equal to false. So actually what will happen here is this will happen when button is clicked. When the button is clicked, it will update all these things. So let us run our program and see. Okay, here it is. So you can see that when the button, okay, when it runs at first, it still has the properties that were set in the design view. Because remember, it has not been dynamic, it's not clicked anything, so it still has the default settings. But the moment we click the button, you'll see that it will change the property. Like if I click, you can see it has changed it has changed some of the properties, though it's not that good, but I think we can make it better. Probably this one, this blue color will not be very amazing. We can say color dot indigo. I don't know about indigo, but I just want to give it something like orange. Okay, no. Gray is more professional. Let's just give it gray. Then, for the foldable, we just come and say, we want a color that will be quite visible. I'll just say that color dot something bright a little bit, or red probably, yeah, dark red, yeah. Okay, this one now I can change to, instead of none, I can change it to fixed single, and then this one, yeah, that one should just remain intact. Then we click, we run the project, the program. Then you can see it still has the default settings. When I click the button, a couple of things have been changed. But we can see that the thing is still also not visible. Yeah. The last name label. And it's not visible because of some good reason. Remember that we had set this one to visibility, we had set its visibility to false. Remember here? Yeah. But we run it, and then we've still not changed the visibility to true. So what we can, the first thing we do is that we change, before we change the font color here, the font color image, we come and say last name label dot visible is equal to true. Then when we run it right now, then you click, you can see now it is true. Okay, I think today we'll stop here. It's not a very amazing program, but it was just for start to give those people who wanted to start programming something to start with. So please remember to subscribe to my channel. Thank you, and please enjoy yourselves. Okay? Okay, thank you.